Hi and welcome back to Code Start with Mohammed Fathi. This is our YouTube channel Code Start. Please don't forget to click on the like button, share the video and leave a comment here. We will continue talking about the state management or the shopping cart state management using the inherited widget. So I am gonna implement this. In the last lecture we have created this app, this list view. You can select item or deselect the item, and when you click on this it will go to the cart details, but this number now is fixed. How to make this shared state or global state with all the widgets? So let me open the VS Code. Here this is a but let me close the bubspec.yaml and let me first make a file here called let me name it cart, file cart dot dart or shopping cart. Let me name this shopping cart dot dart. This will be the inherited widget. It will be, let me first import the material dot dart. After that I'm gonna create this class, this inherited widget class called shopping cart. It will extend the material, the inherited widget, so let me first import the missing methods. So this first method, this class or this inherited widget will contain the information that will be global or shared between all the inherited widget or the all the app. Let me make a list here. This list will be list of product called, for example, products. It will be an empty list like this. After that I'm gonna create a widget field or attribute called a child of type widget. This will be the widget that will be passed through this the constructor of this inherited widget. So let me make the constructor. The constructor will be shopping cart. This constructor will take this dot child, and after that I'm gonna create here this method will rebuild the inherited widget when this change. So I'm gonna use here the import the collection, import collection dot dart. So here I'm gonna use the iterable class called iterable equality dot iterable equality dot equals dot equals. Here I'm gonna compare the two lists. I'm gonna compare this list, so called the products, with this, with the so here I'm gonna this will take an instance of the shopping cart. So with this called old widget dot products. So if let me make this or close this and I'm negate here not. So if this not equal this, I am gonna rebuild the inherited widget. So after that I am gonna create another method. It will return the shopping cart. This method called of, it gonna take the build context called context, and it will return the context dot depend on inherited widget of exact type. So this method will be of type, it will be static. I'm gonna mark this method static. So this method will return the instance of this shopping cart. So here, let me, this is, I think this is now good. Let me go to the main method. So here, the material app here, I'm gonna return, wrap this. I'm gonna wrap this with a widget. Wrap with a widget. The widget, it will be of type shopping cart. So let me save. So now the this is work fine. Okay, let me implement this. So it will show the numbers from the shopping cart. So I am gonna here to the home after the build. Let me go here, and in the build, for example, this I'm gonna declare a variable var or of type shopping cart. You can name it anything. It will be of type shopping cart. I'm gonna name this cart equal shopping cart dot of context. So this will return the instance of the, or be reference to the global variable of the shopping cart. This reference, I'm gonna name this cart. This reference will refer to the global state of this shopping cart. So here inside this, instead of this number, I'm gonna use the cart. So cart dot products dot length. So when you try to save now, it will be the length 0. This is work fine. So when you check this, I'm gonna add this product to the cart. When you go here on the this checkbox, when you instate, so I'm gonna make a condition here, F condition, to check this, if this selected, if the item is selected, I'm gonna add it to the cart here. I'm gonna use the set state, and will be in the same in set state. I am not use the set state. If it, I'm gonna item, I'm gonna make this by adding the cart dot products dot add, and add this product, this one called the items of I. I'm gonna add this item to the list. Else I'm gonna remove this item. Else I'm gonna remove this item from the list. So try to copy this, and here I will remove. So try to save now. When you check, for example, product 2, it will be added to the list. Product another one, it will be added. So when you deselect this, it will be removed from the list. This is work fine. When you go here, I'm gonna show the products here. So by go to the cart details, and also I'm gonna make a variable here. You can make var cart equal shopping cart dot of context to get a reference to the global variable. And here you can, instead of this, I am gonna reference to the cart dot products dot length. So if you try to save now, it will be 0. When you go back and select, for example, product 3 and product 6, when you, this is 2 products, when you go here, click on this item, it will be 2 selected. When you go and add another, for example, another 3, when you now the item in the cart, 5 item in the cart, when you click on this cart, it will be 5 items selected. Select another one, click on this, it will be 6 items selected. So this is the end of this lecture. Before I am ending, using inherited widget, I am not gonna use the inherited widget to the state management. I am gonna use a better solution for the state management, like provider or plug pattern or scope model. So please don't forget to share our video, leave a comment. See you in the next lecture.